How can we properly shade our Raymarched shapes based on lights? That's the topic of today's episode of Raymarching for Dummies series. In the previous episode, I've shown to plot various SDFs to create primitive shapes. Now is the time to properly shade them, right after the intro. Okay, so last time when we were here, I had created a simple ray marger to render different shapes based on these SDFs. Right now, I'm rendering only the capsule onto our box mesh. Now, if I remove this render mode unshaded, I'm getting this weird lighting effect. And before I explain why this is happening, let's look at the simple lighting theory first. Okay, so assume that we have a plane and a light source here. And I know this looks like a sun, but for now, think of it as an omni light. So our light will be casting light rays in all directions. Now let's say our light source has light rays shooting straight down onto our plane. So this part of the plane will lit evenly. Now let's say our light source is casting rays like this, which will hit our plane here. So this part of the plane will not lit evenly because light rays are coming at an angle. Basically, this part of the plane will be brighter than this part of the plane. And to calculate that light intensity in computer graphics, normals are used. So basically, we just take a light direction and we have a plane, so the normals will be pointing straight up. And now we will check if the light direction is pointing exactly opposite to the normal, then we will lit that part with maximum intensity. In this case, our light ray is at 45 degrees off of our normal, so we will only lit that part with half the intensity. And we can do that with dot product of our vectors here, but Godot handles the shading of the object based on lights already for us, so I will not go deeper than this in the theory. Let's just head back to Godot. Okay, so based on what I've said, some of you may have figured out what is going on here. If not, it is perfectly okay. Let me explain. So right now, our normals are based on our box mesh. So our shape will be shaded based on our box mesh's normals. That's why if I look at the object from the top, our capsule will be brighter. If I look at it from this side, which is opposite from our directional light, so light rays are not hitting at this side, hence my capsule looks darker. So to fix this, we need to calculate the normals based on the shape. And calculating the normals are very easy. We will basically get the distance to the surface from a given point, and we'll also calculate the distances to the points that are slightly above, slightly to the right, and slightly in forward direction. So let's create a function, vec3, because it will return our normals, get normals, and it will take our point P as an input. Here let's create a variable, vec3. Normals equals then the closest distance from our point, so SDF of P minus vec3 of SDF of P. Then here I want the distance for the point that is slightly to the right of our point, so I can go P minus vec3, then some small value 0, 0, and it will be the same thing for the points that are slightly above and slightly forward. But there is a better way to write this. So here let's go vec2e, and e stands for epsilon equals vec2 of 0.010. Then here I will go p minus e dot xyy, then sdf of p minus e dot yxy, and finally sdf of p minus e dot yyx. Then simply return our normalized normals. Okay, now that we have our function, let's call it in our fragment processor. Now first we need to calculate the intersection point here to pass it into our getNormals function. So vec3p equals, then we will start at ray origin and go in ray direction this distance units. Then here let's go vec3 normals equals get normals of p. Now let's visualize our calculated normals. So albedo equals normals, and we have nice normals. Ignore this, we are shading for now. Now let's set them as our actual normals. So here let's go normal equals normals and set the color back to gray. So albedo equals vec3 of 0.2, and now our shape is shaded and looks good only until I don't rotate it. And the reason this is happening is right here. My ray origin is in local space. My ray direction is in local space. So naturally, my calculated P will be in local space. And same thing for the normals. But Godot is expecting the normals in view space. So I need to convert my normals in view space. Now we cannot directly go to view space from local space. First, we need to go from local space to world space. And for that, I can use model matrix. Then to go from world to view, I can use view matrix. So view matrix, multiply model matrix. And here be careful not to flip the order, because matrix to matrix multiplication will create new transformation matrix based on reverse order. So first I need to go local to world. Hence, model matrix is here. And now I can multiply our normals, but they are vector 3. Our matrix is 4 by 4, so I need to convert my normals to vec4, which is called homogeneous vector, and fill the last component with value of 1. Then it will return vector 4, so just take the xyz components of the entire thing. Now we have our normals in view space, but our lighting still doesn't look right. And frankly, even I don't know why this is happening. I spent a lot of time figuring out what is the cause of the problem, but that's all in the vain. Let's just visualize our normals again. Now as I move around, our normals are changing weirdly, which means our calculation here is incorrect. And I found a way to fix it by putting 0 here as the fourth dimension instead of 1. And again, I don't know what is the cause for this. This doesn't make any sense to me. Last component of the homogeneous vector should always be 1 when multiplying with a matrix. So if any of you guys know what is going on here, please let me know in the comments. The best explanation will get a pin, and I will also give a shout out in my next video. Okay, so I'm not going to write the solution like this. It doesn't make any sense, and I don't want you guys to create bad habits when transforming vectors. So let me plot model view matrix again. View matrix into model matrix. And I will convert the matrix into 3x3 matrix. Then multiply my normals, so get normals of P. Now let's set our capsule back to gray. And now the capsule is shaded properly. Pretty cool. Now let's take a bit of detour, but please pay attention. Be very careful when doing something like this. Here I can get away by creating a 3x3 matrix only because my model view matrix doesn't have any translation data. If I had translation data, meaning if my matrix would move the vector, then this won't work at all. Let's just see one example real quick. Let's say I have a vector v equals vec3 of 0, 0, 0. And if I visualize it, it will be all black. Now let's say I want to move this vector 1 unit in z-axis. So I will create a transformation matrix here. Mat4 tm for transformation matrix equals mat4. Then I will go vec4 of 1, 0, 0, 0. And in Godot, matrices are in column major order. So this will be my first column. Then vec4 of 0, 1, 0, 0. Then vec4 of 0, 0, 1, 0. And final vec4. And here I want to move 1 unit in z-axis, so 0, 0, and 1. And the last component of the matrix should always be 1. Check out my matrix video if you want to know more about that. So here, if I go transformation matrix multiply our vector, and I need to convert it in vector 4 and fill the last component with 1 and take the RGB components of the entire thing. And RGB is just XYZ, okay? So the vector has moved 1 unit in Z-axis, hence we are getting this blue color here. But if I take a 3x3 matrix of our transformation matrix, I will get only this elements. It won't have the translation data. So the resulting vector will be 0, and we just got the same 0, 0, 0 vector. So keep this in mind when doing something like this. Okay, now here, I'm calculating the transformation vector, which is just a modal view matrix basically. And we already have built-in modal view matrix. It's just that it is only accessible in Vertex processor. So to pass that to Fragment processor, I can use another varying variable, so varying mat3, because we only need 3x3 matrix of modal view matrix, then modal view matrix. In the vertex processor, let's grab our matrix, so modal view matrix equals mat3 of the original modal view matrix. And in our fragment processor, directly use our modal view matrix. I am doing this just to save on tiny little performance. And now our shape is shading properly, even with multiple lights. It is also casting shadows. And it will receive shadows of the other meshes as well. Pretty cool. But we have one issue here. If I render a cube, there is some screw up going on here. And the reason is, here we are getting negative distance. Because in raymarching, we are approximating the intersection point. It is not the exact point. We are just assuming that if the distance is very small, we will count that as a hit. Because of that, sometimes our ray marcher can march inside the shape as well and will return the negative distance. And hence this function is called sine distance function. In ray marching, there is a concept of exterior distance, which is the distance from the outside of the shape, and an interior distance, which is the distance from inside the shape, and it will be in negative. I skipped over it in the previous episode, because at that time, we were not shading the objects, so it would not make any sense. So here we are calculating the exterior distance if our camera is at point P. Now if my point is inside the cube, both this dx and dy will be negative. And to get the interior distance, I just need the bigger value between dx and dy, so I can use max function. However, I only want the interior distance if both dx and dy is negative, so I can use min function over the entire thing like this. Then the actual distance will be the exterior distance plus interior distance. By doing that, our distance will be pulled back onto the surface point. So let's adjust our sdbox function. So this is just the exterior distance, so instead of return go float extd for exterior distance equals this, and I will store this absolute of p minus half size in a separate variable, vec3, I don't know, box distance equals that, then use box distance here. Then for interior distance, I will go float int d for interior distance equals, then I need the greatest value between box distance x, y, and z. So max of box dist dot x, and again max of box distance dot y and box distance dot z. So here I will just get the greatest value between x, y, and z. But I only want that if all three of them are negative, so I can wrap the entire thing in min function. So interior distance will be negative only if all three components are negative, Otherwise, I will simply get the 0. Then just return exterior distance plus interior distance. And our screw up is gone. And we don't have to calculate interior distance for all shapes to save the performance. Sphere, torus, and capsule works just fine, so I won't bother, but we have issues in capped cylinder. Let me just render that. Okay, so the concept is same. Here this D and Y can go negative if we are inside the shape. And we can find the interior distance just as we did with the box like this. So let's go to our SD cylinder function. Here this is the exterior distance, so instead of return, float extd equals that. And here this D and Y can go negative, so the interior distance will be float int equals maximum of D and Y. And again, I only need interior distance if both D and Y are negative, so I can wrap the entire thing in min function. Then simply return exterior distance plus interior distance. And our screw up is gone. Nice. Now, if you have made it this far in the series, congratulations, and I promise that all the boring stuff is now over. In the next episode, we will do something fun. You can find the shader file on my Patreon page, and that's pretty much the video. If you find the video helpful, hit the like button, share it with your friends, subscribe for more videos like this. If you have any questions, post them in the comments. Buy Cosmic Roads on Steam if you wish to support me financially. That's it from me, and I will see you guys in the next one.